What's up, YouTube world? What's up, YouTube world? Hello, friends. How are you? What's going on? You know, it's kind of fun being on here because I don't do YouTube lives very often, but maybe it's something I'm going to get into soon. I wanted to share with you guys something kind of cool. Da 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 da. Book is launched. The Hungry for Happiness book is launched. For those of you guys who have been following my channel since I talked only about food and body, I know I'm talking a lot about breathwork these days on the YouTube channel, but back in the day, I used to just talk about food and body stuff, and that is so much where my passion lies. And so my book has launched today. It is available in all of the major retailers. You can get it on Amazon. I'm going to be putting a link to the book below in the comments. When you purchase the book, you also get access to my 21-day meditation series for free, which is a $50 value. So basically, you're getting the book for free. And I wrote this book for anyone who spends more than a minute a day worrying about food in their body. I struggled with my relationship to food, my relationship to my body forever. And I thought that I would just struggle with it for life. Like, I really didn't think that there was a way to get over emotional eating. I didn't think that there was a way through this battle with food in my body. And so I just like really struggled with it. Every single day I would wake up and I would worry about food, and I would stress out about my body, and I would be on and off the scale 100 times a day. And if that's you and you're watching either live or on the replay, let me know in the comments below. But it's interesting. It's like when you struggle with food addiction, or you struggle with the addiction of exercise, for instance, with food, you can't just stop cold turkey. And so for those people who struggle with emotional eating, and this is something that is really painful for you to deal with on a daily basis, I completely understand. I know what that journey is like. I know how painful it can be to wake up and the first thought on your mind is about food. The first thought on your mind is about your body, or how much weight you have to lose, or just feeling uncomfortable in your body. And, you know, we have this one life with this one body. So what if we designed our life to feel as comfortable as possible in these bodies that we have? And back in the day, 10 years ago, I had no idea how to discern the difference between what is an emotional hunger cue and what is a physical hunger cue. I had no idea how to feel into that. I felt two things in my body. I felt numbness or I felt anxiety. There wasn't anything else. I didn't feel those big states of like joy and bliss. And when people would say, follow your intuition, I had no idea what people were talking about. If you resonate with this, let me know in the comments. So this book is not only the story and the journey of how I was able to overcome it. Oh, it's getting a little, there you go. There's a clear image of it. But it's also an integrative book where every single chapter there is integrative exercises for you to feel supported in your battle with food in your body. So it's part journey and then part integrative exercise. So I am going to go through the table of contents so you can understand what you are getting yourself into. So chapter one is waking up to your truth. So realizing that in order for us to have sustainable transformation, we have to be honest with where we're at. So for so long, I was in denial of where I was at. I didn't want to face the truth, because if I faced the truth, then it meant that I had to do something about it. And I was not yet willing to admit to myself that there was an issue. So that's chapter one. Chapter two is exiting the diet depression. I was on over 50 diets in less than 4 years and struggled so badly with my relationship to food in my body. And so this chapter is about how can we actually begin to get out of it? How can we begin to use food for health and hunger? How can we remove all of the conditioning around dieting? And how can we learn to actually retrust? No pain, no gain. This chapter number three, this is about changing our relationship to pain. So often we feel anxiety in our body and we're like, I'm out of here. I don't want to feel that. And so we use food as a drug to numb that. But anxiety and that pain that we experience in our body is actually such a beautiful catalyst to growth. And so when we change our relationship to pain, we actually begin to grow and evolve. Perfect is the enemy of great. Chapter 4, perfection when it comes to food and body. Let me know if you're a perfectionist in the chat box. But when we are perfectionists and we think we have to be perfect in order to be loved, we begin to just cage ourselves. You know, we begin to cage ourselves. We begin to be so afraid of getting messy. Like one of my mantras that you'll read about in the book is, I will make better mistakes tomorrow, meaning I will constantly evolve and grow and get messy and just break things in order to grow and in order to evolve. Number 5, soothing your inner child. All of us have inner children that all have different needs and all have different parts. And when I first heard about inner child work, it didn't resonate with me at all. I'm like, that sounds like some sort of hippie crap. But then when I began to actually dive into it and learn more about it, I realized like, wow, like this is a huge, huge, huge piece. And this is a huge part. And soothing our inner child and understanding what they need helps us not outsource our needs with food, which is what I did for so long. I just didn't realize it. Number 6, emotional mastery. How can we master our emotions? Our emotions drive our behavior in everything that we do. So how can we understand how to really master our emotions so we can be in that high vibrational state constantly? Number 7, the antidote to self-sabotage. Self-sabotage is so common with people who struggle with emotional eating and binge eating, right? You go ahead and you're like, okay, I got this. I got this. I'm on a diet or I'm doing really good or I haven't emotionally ate in 3 days. And then that voice is like, you're never going to get there. Why even try? And so that chapter is all about how can we reverse that? How can we unwind that? Number 8, taking off the mask. I used to wear this mask that everything is awesome all the time, and I would never actually tell people what was real and tell people my actual feelings. And so this is all about how can we take off the mask? How can we show ourselves to the world? How can we become more vulnerable? How can we really be intimate with ourselves? Discovering intuition and self-liberation. I was convinced I did not have an intuition for the longest time. I'm like, people would say, just follow your intuition or listen to your body. And it was complete, like I was in a complete state of numbness. And so this chapter goes through how can we reawaken our intuition? How can we actually understand how our intuition works and self-liberation? How can we stop being so hard on ourselves and putting so much pressure on ourselves? Number 10, doing the work. What does it actually take to do the work? What does it really take to rewire our relationship to food, rewire our relationship to our body? You know, my philosophy is the bottom-up approach. How can we start in the body and feel to heal so that we shift our behaviors rather than just thinking about, okay, how do I stop emotional eating? It's not just that. It's like, how can I reshift how my body feels from the inside out so that I stop using food as a drug? The death of dieting, how to put it down once and for all. Let me know in the chat box. Let me know in the comments. What would life be like for you if you no longer fought with food? What would life be like if you no longer diet? What if we did not start a diet on a Monday? What would that be like for you? Number 12, intuition is your superpower. Again, unlocking it, how we can stop thinking about how to heal, but actually feel to heal, really getting in our bodies. 13, forgive yourself. If you're anything like me, I had a history of the ways in which I went against myself, the ways in which I was horrible to myself. I berated my body. I didn't trust myself. So this is all about forgiving yourself, cleaning the slate so you can really get back in alignment. Chapter 14, healing emotional eating with breathwork. If you're here and you follow this channel, you know that I am all about breathwork. Breathwork was such a powerful tool in helping me end the battle with food in my body. So healing emotional eating with breathwork is 14. And then 15, the beginning, how we can actually begin our lives, how we cannot use who we used to be in the future, but draw a line in the sand and actually begin to create what we want in the world, begin to create what feels best for us. So those, that is the breakdown of the book. Again, when you purchase the book, you also have access to my 21-day meditation series. So you can go through the meditations as you read the book and go on this beautiful healing journey. So hungryforhappiness.com/book. That's in the comments below. Thank you guys so much. Again, this book is for anyone who struggles more than a minute a day with food and their body. If it is on your mind and you are not thinking about the things that you love and light you up and you're in this battle with food, grab this book, read the chapters, do the integrative exercises. You are supported, you are loved, and this is not something that you are going to struggle with for the rest of your life. This is something that you get to end now. You get to end in this time period. So I love you. Go grab the book and we'll see you soon. Bye for now.